In today's video, we'll share recommended configurations and best practices to help you get the most out of C2 Identity. Synology C2 Identity is a cloud-based identity and access management solution, IAM. Unlike traditional IAM systems, it's easy to use but still powerful, helping businesses and organizations manage accounts, permissions, and devices across both cloud and on-premises environments. With C2 Identity, you can build a secure framework for your organization. It helps reduce the risk of data breaches and keeps identity and access management smooth and efficient. If you're still exploring or uncertain about how to integrate C2 Identity to your current deployment, we've broken the content into 5 sections. We'll walk through how to switch from your existing system, how to set up secure login methods, and how to further enhance security. Now, let's start by planning your IAM solution and deploying it in stages. This will help minimize disruptions to your organization during the transition. We recommend taking a close look at your current setup to spot any limitations or gaps. If your company has multiple account systems, manages devices and services on separate platforms, or runs several Nest devices across different locations, this assessment can help you find areas to improve. Now that you've reviewed your setup, it's time to start rolling out C2 Identity in phases to ensure a smooth implementation. You can start by syncing your existing IAM or identity provider, IDP, data to C2 Identity. For example, your internal systems might currently rely on Synology LDAP servers or Windows Active Directory for management and authentication. With C2 Identity, you can sync these systems to integrate both SaaS applications and device management. Initially, you may still prefer sticking with your existing IAM system to manage accounts and users. This is fine. Just remember that when you add new users or groups, their data will automatically sync with C2 Identity. Your Windows AD or Synology's LDAP server can sync with C2 Identity. This means you'll be able to manage permissions and access directly within the cloud. We recommend introducing C2 Identity gradually, starting with a small group or department. This way, you can work through any issues during the rollout, then expand gradually to the whole organization. Once all user data is synced to C2 Identity, you can move all systems and services over and stop maintaining the old servers. This way, there's no need to maintain legacy servers anymore. Next, we'll move on to how C2 Identity manages local services using edge servers. Now, while C2 Identity is a cloud service, you might think it can't handle local services. But with edge servers, it can. Edge servers let you manage permissions and user accounts for local services while unifying your cloud and on-premises account systems. Everything comes together in one seamless framework. Previously, your organization may have relied on a central LDAP server at headquarters to manage access to key services across the company. For branch offices, this often means connecting to HQ through a VPN to authenticate. But VPN connections can become a bottleneck, slowing things down. On top of that, when all authentication requests go through a single centralized server, it can lead to delays and congestion. And for local services, like Wi-Fi or on-premises LDAP, branches often face two scenarios. Some may set up their own separate authentication systems, while others might not have any system at all, leaving individual servers to handle their own account and services. Either way, this makes access control more fragmented and harder to manage across the organization. With C2 Identity, branch offices can set up an edge server on their local NAS. This allows user and group data to sync from the centralized C2 Identity directory to edge servers, so all accounts are managed in one unified system. Local authentication through edge servers means no more relying on the central server for every login, reducing delays and avoiding bottlenecks. The result? Faster, smoother access for everyone at the branch. Now that all your accounts are unified, the next step is making sure they're secure. C2 Identity supports passwordless authentication, and as an admin, you can enforce it for all accounts right from the settings page. With passwordless authentication enabled, you and your team won't need to rely on traditional passwords anymore. Instead, you can log in using secure options like biometrics or the Secure Sign-In app, with time-based one-time passwords or push notifications. This way, only someone who can unlock their device can access accounts and computers, keeping everything safe from password theft, leaks, or brute force attacks. And it's not just for cloud services. You can also use passwordless authentication to log into Windows, using the same secure methods. It's all about making security seamless and stress-free for you and your team. Next, some services, like SMB or Wi-Fi, don't support passwordless logins. In these cases, users can go to the C2 Identity User Portal to quickly and easily generate a strong, reliable application password. The best part? These passwords can be securely saved in C2 Password along with other sensitive information, so users don't have to worry about forgetting or losing them. It's secure and it's hassle-free. C2 Password is also perfect for securely storing personal identity details, such as passports and driver's licenses, or any sensitive information you want to keep safe. To keep passwords secure, encourage users to generate strong, reliable passwords with the password generator in C2 Password. When users create weak or reused passwords, it can put your entire system at risk. C2 Identity's C2 Password service lets users securely store their strong passwords in a vault, making it easy for them to stay safe without worrying about remembering every password. For example, you can create a customized login page that reflects your organization's branding with your logo, favicon, and color scheme. This not only makes it easier for employees to recognize, but also helps protect against phishing attempts. You can also use your organization's domain to customize the web address for both the login portal and user portal. This way, employees can continue using a familiar URL, making the transition to C2 Identity smooth and hassle-free. Once your passwords and logins are secure, it's time to focus on centralized user and access management. Here are some best practices. First, create user groups based on roles or departments. This makes it easier to manage permissions for multiple users at once and keeps things consistent. When an employee switches to a new team or role, all you need to do is to move users between groups. On and offboarding requires no more than a few clicks to complete. Next, automate IT's management permissions for devices, allowing IT to retain admin access to all newly joined devices. Finally, you can also assign access to shared SaaS accounts through individual C2 identity logins. This keeps SaaS accounts secure and ensures only authorized users have access. C2 Identity includes advanced features to enhance the login experience. For added security, we recommend using the main Synology account only for subscription management and payments. Everyday tasks like managing accounts and access permissions should be delegated to your IT team. This reduces the risk of breaches and ensures a balanced workload across your team. After going through these 5 sections, you should now have a better grasp of C2 Identity and how it can help your organization. Strengthening identity and access management is not just about security. It's about creating a smoother, more efficient IT environment. If you have any questions or help getting started, check out our documentation or reach out to us.